outside the O-Dome. This was about 90 minutes ago. Wrapped around the building, ready to come inside for a big showdown, a top 15 showdown. The Florida Gators, ranked 13th in the country, welcome in the Stanford Cardinal, the nation's 12th ranked team. Great to have you with us here in Gainesville with Holly McPeak. I am Eric Fried, and there are so many great non-conference matchups on the volleyball schedule. Add this one to the list. Let's start with Stanford. We're just 3 years removed from back-to-back national championships for the Cardinal. Does this year's team have what it takes to get back to the national championship?
Head coach Kevin Hambley says, look, we have all that we need. He's built this team around a very athletic setter, Cammy Miner. She's just a setter, but she is something special, elite, one of the best in the country. And then on the opposite pin, Kendall Kipp, she's got the size and all-around game to be very dangerous. But Katie Baird on the left side pin can do it all and often goes unnoticed because of Kipp's numbers.
So it's a team that has experience. This is a Florida team that's got a lot of talent, but they are young.
Florida is rebuilding, but if you're going to rebuild, rebuild around a talented freshman setter. Alexis Stuckey is something special. At 6'2", she's got the size, beautiful hands, coach's dream. And then Merritt Beeson on the right side has really emerged into a physical opposite. She had a great summer with the USA U21, earning MVP at the Pan Ams.
Co-offensive player of the week in week one in the SEC, off to a great start this season. Great crowd, loud crowd. We're ready to go here in Gainesville. Ellie McKissick will start things here against Stanford. Tough set at the beginning and an early point for Florida.
Stanford's starting in a rotation with a front row setter. So they're trying to split the blockers going left and right, but that one pretty predictable.
Overpass, another chance for Florida. Contact with a net and two early points for the Gators.
It's interesting, when we talked to Mary Wise this week, she said we have to try and get them out of system, but they are still good out of system. Right now, Florida just jumping all over Stanford, first 2 points with a tough serve.
Mary Wise in her 32nd season as Florida's head coach. Team coming off a very impressive win against Virginia, swept the Cavaliers. That's off hands in the first point. Goes to the Cardinal.
That time, well-located ball to 22 in black. Katie Barrett, high off the hands.
Stanford 2-0 on the season. Picked up two victories in Nashville over Lipscomb and Tennessee State. Got here to Gainesville yesterday, practice last night, and again this morning. That's deflected out of play, and Florida back on top by two.
That's a nice decision by Merritt Beeson to go high, flat off the hands of that big block of Stanford. That's when you use the big block to your advantage.
Beeson had 12 kills, hit 588 last match for Florida. That was a win against Virginia. Quick set and a kill for the Cardinal.
Stanford, when in system, going right to McKenna Vicini, number 14. Love starting and establishing that middle early off of a good pass.
Vicini, one of the middles for this team out of Lexington, Kentucky. Baird serves. Stuckey sets. Point Florida.
Stuckey to Kelly. They had a good summer together getting those reps. Again, they were representing USA at the Pan American Games and had an opportunity to play together. That really helps cement that relationship between setter and middle attacker.
So this is a young team. One of their experienced players when it comes to playing at the Division I level comes in, but she's new to the program. Marina Markova, who transferred in from Syracuse. That one bounces around and out of play. Another point for Florida. There you see Markova wearing number 22 in her career at Syracuse. Averaged just under 4 kills a set. So stepping right in and making an impact in the early going with her new program, Florida. 14 kills against Virginia last match. Miner sets. Good block by the Gators. They get it again. McKissick saves it. No getting this one, though. Big swing from the left side and a point for the Cardinal.
But fantastic defense by Florida to keep that ball alive, extending that rally.
Elia Rubin, freshman from Brentwood, California, played at Marymount Gatorade Player of the Year last year, getting that kill. You are very high on what you think she's going to be able to do here for Stanford as a freshman.
Well, she's just got that all-around game, that first contact, especially at the elite level. How about Markova, number 22 in right. Low, hard seam. Very effective right there, but credit Alexa Stuckey for delivering that ball quickly out to the pin.
Bree Kelly to serve. Blocked back, but out of play. Point for the Cardinal.
Mary Wise likes that matchup. Markova facing Kendall Kipp, one of the bigger Stanford attackers, facing the biggest block for Florida.
Kendall Kipp back to serve. Stuckey looks for Markova again. Good block. Point's not over yet. Florida started to celebrate, but Stanford stuck with it. And after that, Stanford's going to get the point.
Love the cover play. Stanford never gave up. Even on that ball, it looked like it was going down. And then Elia Rubin finds that line open on the second attack.
Overpass and a point at the net for Sammy Francis. Francis now playing the middle. She was an outside hitter last year. Kevin Hambley, the Stanford head coach, thinks this is the best position for her.
Yeah, you know, when she first came into Stanford, they wanted to move her to the left side. They thought she could have a bigger impact on the game, and they figured out after 2 years that she has a much bigger impact and is more comfortable out of the middle with her size.
Hitting error for Beeson, point for Stanford, and the Cardinal have gone on a 4-0 run for Hambley in his sixth season, 14th overall. Winning two national championships at Stanford. Stuckey for Markova. Blocked back, another point for Stanford. It's a 5-0 run for the Cardinal.
Sammy Francis, 17 in black, getting there, closing that block. She is so good laterally, and that's what makes her really strong in the middle as a middle blocker.
Great service run here for the senior, Kendall Kipp. Beeson out of the back row. Blocked back, and the Stanford run continues.
Sammy Francis so disciplined, staying there, reading that play. Great eye work. Watch 17 in black in the middle. She sees her hitter and sees which way she's going and takes it away from her.
Kipp serves again. Another good serve. And another point for Stanford. And I think Mary Wise may want a timeout here. And she will come out and take the timeout. What a run for the Cardinal. A 7-0 run right now for Stanford, playing here in Gainesville, up 4 in the first. Time between Stanford and Florida, all Cardinal right now. It's a 7-0 run. Why have they gone on this run, Holly?
It's all about the serving and the defense, and that's something Stanford does really well. They serve tough, put tons of pressure on the serve receive team, and then they've got huge blocks at the net, and they're very disciplined with their block moves. Kendall Kipp continues to roll for Stanford from the back line.
Kendall Kipp, second team All-American last year, was all Pac-12, was second on the team in kills per set. She picks up an ace here, had 5 in the first 2 matches of the season, and she is locked in right now on the serve. And finally the run ends as Markova gets the kill.
Markova able to get that low seam and finally drop for Florida and getting Kendall Kipp off that back line.
So Markova, a couple of kills to pace this Florida team. Trying to slow down the Stanford run. Oh, good quick set by the freshman, Stuckey, to Gabby Essex.
What a feed in transition. Stuckey feeling so good, getting Gabby Essex 10 and white in a perfect position to score.
It's really remarkable to watch Alexis Stuckey and what she's been able to do so far for this Florida team. The freshman from Laramie, Wyoming, who was at Laramie High School a year ago, comes in, has some really big shoes to fill. Marley Monterey, who was a fixture at the center position for Florida. And she has gotten off to a great start to her Florida career. Good point there for Sammy Francis with the kill for Stanford.
Sammy Francis going behind the setter. Good off one foot. She's just so long and has so much offensive range.
Elia Rubin set to serve for the Cardinal. Stuckey works it to the middle. Essex again.
Textbook side out by Florida. Perfect pass. And Stuckey gets that ball quick to Gabby Essex in a high spot. Watch this contact point. Good speed, high contact. I mean, she can go over any block at that contact point.
Mary Wise has said about Gabby Essex, the sophomore from Hoover, Alabama, great arm, can thunder the ball. We've heard that thunder a couple of times already. And now, bringing a little bit more. The joust at the net, using that strength to get the point for Florida.
Well, Florida's returning the favor. They started this match, tough serves from the service line. Here, Gabby Essex wins the battle at the net.
Markova has a real strong serve, but has trouble getting it in at times. Sixth service error of the season to go along with four aces. It is the textbook go for it serve, all or nothing.
Yeah, it's a hybrid, but she puts a lot of pace on it. They said she averages, you know, between 40 and 55 miles per hour. That's pretty good.
Stanford by three, set one, best of five. Stuckey goes to Beeson. Blocked out of play, point for Florida.
Merritt Beeson doing a nice job for Florida, using the high hands out of bounds in her favor.
First three matches, 12 kills, 17 kills, 12 kills in the three wins for Florida here at the O-Dome this weekend.
Stanford in a two-hitter rotation right now.
McKissick with the serve, and that's a service error. Service error number two for Florida. Cammie Miner, setter for Stanford, back to serve. The Pac-12 freshman of the year last season. She has Stanford's first service error of the evening. Merritt Beeson back to serve. Point Florida.
Kendall kept trying to get that ball outside of the block and inside the defense of Florida, but just wide.
Beeson, the team leader, coming into tonight's match with 10 aces through the first three matches of the season. That one is long, hitting error for Stanford, and Florida has tied things up. Remember, it was an 8-0 run for Stanford that put Kevin Hambley's team up 11-6. Good response by the Gators. Another good serve by Beeson. Stuckey to Bree Kelly. Blocked back, kept alive by Stanford. Stuckey to Kelly.
one of the things that makes Alexis Stuckey pretty special is her size. At 6'2" for a setter, she's a big blocker on the right side, and right now having some success against Kendall Kipp on that left pin.
Good service run here by Merritt Beeson. 4-0 run for the Gators. Stuckey sets it up for A.C. Fitzpatrick. Penn State transfer in her first season with the Gators. Gets the kill, forcing Stanford to take a timeout here in set one.
Mary Wise talked about getting Stanford out of system, but Florida's doing an extremely good job of getting easy swings in transition from Stanford.
Swings and momentum here in the first set. Florida had a good start. Cardinal went on a run. Now the Gators are running it back. Our opening night of college football on the SEC Network kicks off on Thursday, 7 Eastern time. Hendon Hooker and the Tennessee Volunteers will host Ball State in Knoxville. You can see it right here on the SEC Network and also on the ESPN app. Hooker, quarterback to watch this year, preseason Manning Award and O'Brien watch list. Passed for almost 3,000 yards a year ago. All right, this has been a first set of trends and runs, and right now it's trending Florida's way.
Yeah, it's fun, right? This is preseason. Both these teams are trying to figure out who they are. They haven't necessarily been pushed. So they're trying to figure it out, and they're both good tests for one another. They've both got size. Both teams are serving extremely well. It's been fun to watch.
From Stanford's point of view, this is a team, when we talked to Kevin Hambley about it this week, he likes this team. You talked about it right at the top of the telecast. Very athletic. They can fly around the floor. In his words, he said, it's not a question if we're capable, but he wants to know whether or not they can compete.
Yeah, and when their backs are against the wall, what are they going to do? How are they going to respond? I feel like they can definitely pick up their passing. That will help keep them in system, because when they are in system, they're hard to stop.
So each team has used a timeout so far. You see Mary Wise, 32nd season at Florida, 1,004 wins and counting. She's been the head coach since 1991, racking up 24 SEC titles. More good defense by Florida. Sets up Beeson off hands and a low point for the Gators.
Starts with a really nice dig by McKissick, and then Beeson out of the backcourt. Another available attacker in transition for Florida.
6-0 run for the Gators. Beeson has mixed up her serve too, keeping Stanford off balance. And a point for Stanford, and that ends the run.
But consistently, Florida has been getting Stanford out of system, not passing well, and that's something Kevin Hamley's going to have to focus on when they get a timeout or in between sets.
There's Katie Baird, team leader in kills each of the last 2 years for the Cardinal. Oh, once again, we've seen that play before with Stuckey setting it up for Kelly.
And Bree Kelly attacking against the smaller of the two left side pin hitters, and Elia Rubin, the freshman.
Substitutions for the Gators. Trinity Adams, sophomore, will come on to serve. Emily Canan will check out. Markova is back in. And a good kill from the right side, put away by Kendall Kipp. Kill for
Kendall Kipp. When Stanford's in system, Kendall Kipp can really hurt you on that right side pin.
Member of the 2019 National Championship team at Stanford. Stuckey, Markova.
Again, Markova attacking that seam. Sammy Francis needs to close that block. You see her getting that big gap between the two Stanford blockers, and Markova can accelerate her arm and attack between that gap.
Sorry, Holly, when Florida took that early timeout, they were hitting negative in this first set. Right now they're hitting 348. That gives you an idea how things have flipped since that Stanford
run. Complete flip. Stanford hitting 182 and Florida hitting 348. Those are really nice numbers against a strong defensive team like Stanford.
Service error number three for Florida. Point for Stanford. 2-point advantage for the Gators. Cardinal serving. Dug out by McKissick. Markova.
The defense of Florida in such great spots. They did their scouting report, and we saw them go over it today. They went over how they wanted to serve, receive, and the defensive looks they wanted to give Stanford, and it's paying off right now.
I'd like to pay off this crowd. They just did my work for me. They were saying what I was going to say. That was a great point, and they were into it the entire time. That one will be in for Stanford and a point for the Cardinal. Florida the first team to 20 here in set one, but point for Stanford.
I think Coach Mary Wise for Florida needs to be, or is, very happy with what she's seen from this team. She knew this would be a very big test.
Stuckey, Beeson, dug out and kept in. But only for the moment. Good hustle play by Cammie Miner and Stanford, but it's a point for Beeson and the Gators. A.C. Fitzpatrick back on for Florida. All right, here could be the difference in this first set for the Gators. Can Markova get this big serve in? Stanford's ready for it. Stuckey to Beeson. Oh, Miner, crafty to get the point.
Florida getting some good-looking transition opportunities, but Stanford able to win that rally with the kill.
So Miner gets the kill, 21-19 as we play to 25 here in set one. Kelly Bilardi, freshman from Manhattan Beach, California, comes on the serve. Stuckey once again. That combination with Essex has been on point.
The physicality of Gabby Essex, number 10 in white, and the feed from Alexis Stuckey, number 5. The just connection is pretty darn amazing. That's tough to stop.
Ellie McKissick to serve the game. Ellie McKissick will serve. Florida up three points away from taking set one. Back row swing, kill, and a point for Stanford.
For Stanford, it starts with a good first contact. Cammie Miner had all her options open, and that puts a lot of pressure on the Florida block and opens up that big play out of the back row.
Miner serves. Stuckey to Fitzpatrick, little off balance. Chance here from Stanford. McKissick digs it. Great hustle play, keeping it in play by Fitzpatrick. We play on.
Can we talk about the hustle? Both sides going into the table, knocked our monitors over, but look at the hustle. A.C. Fitzpatrick gives it her all, and then the rest of the team shuttles to the other side as well. Wow.
Everything's still working on
yeah,
your side
I
of the table?
So.
Okay, we'll check during the break. By the way, this is an August match, technically, and they're playing like we're in December. That's just that intensity that we're feeling right here.
Well, both programs know this is a great early test, and they're hungry for this challenge.
Florida takes a timeout. Stanford gets another point. We're even at 22 here in set one. So Florida uses their second and final timeout of this first set. Gainesville's premier Vietnamese Cajun restaurant. So this is good for us because we had stuff knocked all over the place by, I think it was A.C. Fitzpatrick, right?
Was,
that was the number
was,
of that truck
yes.
that trucked us. Well, is everything
Everything's
check
working.
Check one, two. Everybody can hear us okay? Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
We're all set.
We're fine.
I'm just glad she's okay. I don't care about my stuff.
I don't think she cared about anything. She didn't care about her well-being. I don't care about our
sacrifice
well-being. We were fine.
Well, it's team first, according to Mary Wise. That's part of her culture is team first, and she was giving it all for her team.
I was prepared if she was, if AC was in front of us to jump in front of her to protect my teammate.
Oh,
honestly,
thank you. What a great teammate.
I truly mean that. Okay, take us in the huddles right now. 22-22. We've had the runs right now. Cardinal making that run.
Well, Stanford needs some better stops defensively, and then they need to really crack down on their first contact and control that better, because in terms of first contact, Florida definitely controlling that better.
Well, Florida was on top 22-19, three straight points run off by the Cardinal. Third time we've been tied in this first set. Mentioned the runs for each team. Stanford had an 8-0 run. They went up by 5 in set 1. Florida answered later with a 6-0 run to lead by 3. Here's Cammy Miner trying to keep this run going for the Cardinal. That's going to head out of play. That stops the run. Point for Florida.
Florida successful in their side-out game, passing well. Stuckey does not have to move very much, and she's got the arms to put that ball away.
Merritt Beeson with 4 kills and a couple of digs here in the first set, now serving for the Gators. Block! Kelly! Set point, Florida!
Bree Kelly was on the other side of the net before that hit happened, and that was a straight down stuff block. Wow.
Stanford will use their final timeout of the set, facing a Florida set point.
Watch the hands of Bree Kelly. I mean, there is nowhere to go for Katie Baird. Boom.
Kelly, the sophomore who did not make her first career start until October 20th last year as a freshman. Made the all-freshman team in the SEC, preseason all-SEC this season. Yeah,
Coach,
deep breath
yeah,
everyone.
Coach Mary Wise just talked about her work ethic, and we saw her personality today at practice. Just a lot of fun, lots of fire. She loves being part of this program here at Florida. And she bought in, you know, buying in and doing the work. Before she came here, she could not hit off one foot very well, but she committed to learning and getting better. And that's the kind of growth that Mary Wise gets out of her players, because they love the culture here.
You know, Kelly obviously got the time we mentioned as a starter last year. Just think about what Florida, and you talked about rebuilding. Maybe you could look at it as reloading as well, but when you lose pieces like Montserrat, the setter we talked about, Thayer Hall was all SEC on the outside, 10th on the all-time kills list. Lauren Forte, strong in the middle. T.R. Caesar led the team in kills in 19 matches. Those are the pieces that are gone. These are the new faces and the new pieces for Florida, and they have a set point against Stanford in this top 15 showdown in Gainesville. You heard the crowd. Yes, yes for Florida. No, no, whatever. Stanford hit it, but it's a point for Stanford.
Tradition here at Florida, when they've got set point, that's what you're going to hear. Yes, yes on the Florida contacts. No, no on the Stanford contacts.
Set point number 2 for the Gators. Crowd's confused. That was a no for Florida, a yes for Stanford. We will play extras. You have to win by two, even at 24.
Katie Baird going down the line, that area five serve, able to get Florida out of system. We haven't seen Stuckey have to run all over the court like we've seen Cammie Miner on the other side.
Katie Baird leading Stanford back from the service line. Stuckey sets Beeson. Fitzpatrick, big swing, big point Florida.
AC Fitzpatrick, she loves the hardball, but this time really nice decision there. That low seam sneaks it inside the Stanford middle block.
She'll check out. Trinity Adams will come on and serve for the set. Set point number three for the Gators. Off fingers, and we'll keep going. Tied at 25.
Cammie Miner to Vicini in the middle, goes flat off the hand. Set was a little bit low, but good offensive decision to hit that ball flat.
Can have a delay here to mop up the floor. This will go on through the night because intensity level's been high. Player's been laying out right from the start. Helena Ogilvie to serve. Fifth tie of the first set. And a football violation on Ogilvie. Set point number four for Florida.
You don't see that called very often, especially at such a crucial point in the game.
Bree Kelly will serve for Florida. Blocked out of play, point Stanford.
Pretty set by Cammie Miner to that right side pin. Good height, nice speed. That's where Kip does her best work. High altitude attacker.
Kip will head back to serve. Stuckey sets the middle again for Essex.
When Gabby Essex is in the front row for Florida, Stanford has had no answer. They have not dug her nor blocked her, and she is really dangerous.
Set point number five for the Gators. The freshman Stuckey serves. Blocked out of play, and we're tied again.
Kip out of the back row. Nice pipe attack. Keeping Stanford alive. Good back and forth battle with everything on the line.
Can Stanford get over the hump here and set up a set point of their own? Rubin serves. Beeson puts it down, and another set point for the Gators.
Because Florida has established Gabby Essex in the middle, that puts so much pressure on Sammy Francis to wait in the middle, and she's late closing that outside block, and the left side pins are having a good night so far for Florida.
20 first set kills for the Gators. Markova. Another service error. That is the fourth of the first set for the Gators. Tied again. Freshman Kelly Bellardi will focus the best she can and lock in. Beeson rips it.
Pretty good serve by freshman Kelly Bellardi of Stanford, but Florida gets right back in system. Nice first ball side out.
Seventh set point for Florida. McKissick will try to end it. That one is in, and Stanford again fights off a set point.
Freshman Elia Rubin just nailed that pass for Stanford. put them right back in system, and they're able to get out of that rotation where they only had two hitters in the front row.
Cammie Miner serves. Stuckey tries it again to Beeson, who is out of sync. And finally, Stanford has a set point.
That ball set too tight to the net, and the Stanford blockers got it first.
Great defense by the Cardinal. And they cash in with the kill to take set one. What a fight by Stanford to win it 31-29.
Ogilvy with a fantastic dig to finally stop the middle attack from Florida and win that first set.
What a set here in Gainesville. We could have four more of these. Just let you know, settle in, because that was a great first set. Set two coming up when we come back. To set points, and Stanford with the defense that turned into offense.
Florida has been so good out of the middle, but that time Elena Ogilvy, the libero for Stanford, comes up with a huge dig and Kip able to put it away in transition.
Numbers from the first set, kills advantage for Florida, blocks advantage for Stanford, and both teams ended up hitting above 325 in that first set. But the key numbers within those numbers, Stanford fought off seven set points that Florida had in that first set to win that opening set.
Yeah, it was impressive. I thought Stanford competed well at the end, but overall I felt like Florida controlled most of that first set with their tough defense, their really nice first contact and serve receive, and using all their hitters, hitting high percentage balls. Especially those middle attackers, Bree Kelly and Gabby Essex, have been really good for Florida.
So the two teams switch ends and benches for set number two in this best of five. So it's not an unfamiliar position for the Gators. This is their fourth match of the season. It's the third time they've lost the opening set in four matches this year, and they come into this match 3-0 on the season. It's not a trend that Mary Wise probably loves, but she likes the end result from the first three matches. See, it could happen here tonight against Stanford.
Yeah, it's how you respond, and I feel like your team learned something about themselves. Obviously, you don't want to lose the first set, but if you respond and you get back on track, that's a good thing.
Individually, Kendall Kipp leading the way for Stanford with eight kills at 375 in the opening set. Meredith Beeson with six kills for Florida. And Gabby Essex had a strong first set, five kills hitting 444. Bree Kelly as well, four kills hitting 667. Stanford to serve to open set two. And a service error to open set two. That was costly to Florida in the first set, four service errors in that first set.
If you look back at that first set, Stanford actually had two aces. Florida only had one, but Florida had Stanford out of system most of that first set.
In that first set, nine ties, three lead changes. Stuckey had to reach out just to try to keep it alive, and that's easy pickings for the Cardinal, who evened it up here in set two.
Kendall Kipp had open net. That ball popped over. She was ready.
Off hands and then out of play as Stuckey was unable to save it.
One of the biggest challenges for a freshman left side pin player like Elia Rubin is learning how to play against a block that's touching 10-5. And this is a big challenge. She's got a huge block, Bree Kelly and Alexis Stuckey in front of her.
That's deflected. That will drop in. Point for Florida. 2-2. Fitzpatrick.
AC Fitzpatrick played her earlier years at Penn State. She's a local athlete who wanted to come back and play for Florida.
From Ocala.
Yeah,
That was Beeson who saved it. Beeson saved it again. Beeson tried to put it away, but it's Stanford there with the block and a point for the Cardinals.
McKenna Vicini was second in the Pac-12 last year with blocks. She's a very strong middle blocker as a defender. They'd like to get more offense out of her, and that's something they've been working on.
Average better than one block a set last year, 1.3 to be exact. Ogilvy floats it in. Blocked back in the Stanford defense, turning things up here at set two.
Kendall Kipp, Sammy Francis, huge block on that left side pin. Nowhere to go for Fitzpatrick.
Six blocks for Stanford, two for Florida. That's on a play and a point for Kelly in Florida.
Kelly going high off the head of one of the Stanford blockers, not sure which one. Florida's doing some fun stuff in their serve receive. They're showing a two-person formation and then last second adjusting to three.
Another point for the Gators, tied at four.
You can't ease up against that gigantic long block, number 22 in white, Markova out of Russia. Big blocker for Florida.
First team all ACC for Syracuse last year, was 16th in the country, 4.5 kills a set. She knows how to finish. Stuckey runs into the scores table again. And I think this is her default setting. Gets up smiling. The time I look at her, she's smiling. She's someone, I don't know who handles the Laramie, Wyoming recruiting for the Florida staff, but they found a winner and someone who brings a lot of great energy to this Florida program already. Oh, good defense by Stanford. They were ready for Markova with the block.
That time, Cammy Miner and Sammy Francis getting out, closing that seam. Good push out to the pin, but nice close block for Stanford that time.
Caught the tape on the serve. Kelly with the point.
Bree Kelly, that sneaks that one again through that low seam. Stanford's got to get disciplined, pressing over the net, sealing that ball with their block.
Kelly will head back to serve for Florida, but first we'll mop things up on the floor. Six-five Stanford after they took set one, 31-29. Big swing, but long from the freshman Rubin.
Elia Rubin is a very strong passer, but she's pulling that pass off the net. And then the Stanford offense becomes predictable, and she's the only option, hits that one long.
Set back for Francis, and off of Adams and out of play, point for the Cardinal.
That time, Sammy Francis able to get involved because the pass was better by the freshman Rubin of Stanford.
Francis, all freshman in the Pac-12 last year. Averaging three kills a set in the early going this year. 7-6 Stanford. Good job by McKissick to save it. Battle at the net, bounces around, and it will be a point for Florida. Four hits by Stanford.
Correct, too many touches. Florida putting tons of pressure on Stanford, especially on those tight balls.
We had nine ties in set one that went extra. Five ties already here in set two. Hey, Florida was ready for Miner that time. Stuckey sets it back for Beeson. Good block. Francis teaming up with Baird.
Katie Baird got most of that by closing that seam with her right hand. Nice push there by 22 in black. Kelly Bellardi, just a freshman, but she sent her high school team last year to the mythical national championship going undefeated. So she's been in big matches. She was a setter for the Marymount team out of Los Angeles.
Kevin Handley gave her one of the highest compliments you can, or what I think a student athlete would want to hear. He said, she's a baller.
She is.
And she's a baller. That you hear that. Thanks,
right?
Coach. I'm good.
That's all. Yep. She's a legacy athlete. Her father swam in two U.S. trials for swimming and was a student at Stanford as well. Net violation, block from Florida. Stanford able to get that point.
Puts the Cardinal back in front here in set two.
I love watching Alexis Stuckey, the freshman setter for Florida. She is just so mature. She looks like she's having the time of her life. I think she's been waiting for this moment to play at this level for a long time.
Beeson off hands, point for Florida. Well, it's interesting the matchup here today because Cammie Miner, who just served for Stanford, she was the Pac-12 Freshman of the Year, a freshman setter in the Pac-12 for Stanford, and now you've got a freshman in Stuckey setting in the SEC for Florida. They're thrown right into some very challenging conditions.
Yeah, but they're both elite athletes on the international level as well. Both of them have played for Team USA, and you see it pay off. They step into these big roles at the collegiate level.
Montserrat for Beeson finds the opening in the center of the floor from the point for Florida.
There's a couple times I've seen Merritt Beeson put the ball away where I didn't think she had anywhere to go. Well-formed block by Stanford. She goes, finds a way to tool it, and then that time finding the middle of the court open defensively.
Ellie McKissick back to serve. Miner with a quick set to Vicini, who hammers it home.
Really pretty feed to Vicini, one-on-one, and she's able to put that ball away for Stanford.
Third kill for McKenna. And a service error here for Katie Baird.
Florida's doing some fun stuff. Like I said earlier, in serve receive, they're lining up a certain way, and then they move, and that makes the server think about it. Takes them out of their routine.
If you were serving and you saw that, what would you do to try to stay in your routine?
I would just regroup. I would take a second once I saw the movement and then serve. But it does take you out of your rhythm when there's movement and you've already keyed on the spot that you're serving.
Block for Kendall Kipp. Going to Stanford.
Cardinal get another point. Give it to Kendall Kipp. Ogilvy started on one side. Now she'll move to another side. Florida takes a couple steps up. On the kill.
Pretty left side block by Elia Rubin, number 13 in black, and then Kipp with the transition swing on the right pin. Stanford looking much more comfortable.
So now we'll take a look from this angle. Let's see if Florida moves right before the serve.
Right, they just shifted. Now they're shifting back. Now they've got four players.
At the net, that heads out of play, and it's a point for Kelly in Florida.
Bree Kelly using the blocker's hands again, going off that one foot, an area she really worked on last year to establish.
Trinity Adams on the serve for the Gators. Mason with the dig. Big swing from Rubin. Point Cardinal.
Great hang time by Elia Rubin, 13 in black, turning that ball down the line. Looked like in the early part of that rally there was a net violation.
Stuckey got there. Oh, there's Miner. Little bit of a smile after that one, caught the tape and dropped down. Goes into the book, says a kill for the sophomore.
It's important if you're a front row setter and you're able to get up and do that. You want to establish yourself as a weapon so the blockers don't cheat and hang out on your pins.
And a battle at the net. That point will go to the Cardinal, and that will get Stanford to 15, and it will get us to a timeout. So it's been very close here in set two, but now Stanford with their largest lead of this second set, up by three. Good morning for extensive SEC game previews. First at 9 a.m. Eastern, Marty and McGee will be live from Fayetteville, latest from around the conference. That's followed by a two-hour SEC Nation that takes you right up to kickoff, both right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. I'm sure they'll have quite the discussion about Florida starting their season. Gators will be across the street Saturday night. See that on ESPN when they take on seventh-ranked Utah. Out of the media timeout, it's a service error for Stanford and a point for Florida.
Anytime Florida gets Kendall Kipp off that back line, it's a good thing. Stanford tends to go on long runs when Kipp's up the service line.
Stanford's run in the first set was an 8-0 run that put them up by five. Florida answered back with a big run. They had seven set points, but Stanford pulled out the set one win. There is Rubin with another kill.
Elia Rubin, she got blocked, reset, and then found another part of the court to attack, and that was a very sharp angle inside the middle blocker of Essex from Florida.
Good hitting numbers for Stanford this set. They're at 364 here in set two. Florida hitting at 053. Markova will up that number. Big swing and a kill.
Markova is very rangy. You see her long, thin arms, but she's got a whip of an arm, tough to stop, and hits with kind of crazy range. You see her hit some strange angles that you wouldn't think are possible.
Well, she can pile up the numbers, too. She had seven matches with 20 kills or more last year. Off hands and out of play, point for the Cardinal.
Florida put two blockers up. When Kipp is in the back row, and she's still finding a way to score.
Taylor Bevan will come on for the Cardinal. She wears number four. Sammy Francis to serve. That one is long, and it's a point for Stanford.
Florida has not made a lot of hitting errors, but that time, Fisa does not get on top of the ball.
Timeout, Florida.
It's the largest lead of the set for Stanford. They're up by four, and as a result, Florida will use their first timeout. Well, we saw plenty of highlights in the first set of this match, and in the second set, plenty of highlights from the first week of the college volleyball season. Unfortunately, there was also an incident at BYU that's made headlines. Duke's Rachel Richardson was the target of racial slurs and threats from a spectator during the match against the Cougars in Provo on Friday. Holly Rowe spoke to the Duke sophomore about the incident and what she hopes everyone can take from it.
I felt as though responding to it in the way that I did would help the greater purpose, and that's creating awareness, and that's allowing everyone from both sides to better see the fact that we should all be working towards a common goal. We shouldn't be trying to create two sides. What I want the most out of this, one, is to raise awareness, and two, to hopefully encourage institutions such as BYU and others to start really putting in those efforts and the funds to educate the general student body.
Very impressive.
Rachel Richardson, she's inspired athletes to speak up, and she's really sparked conversations across the country. Everybody is talking about it. What can we do better to educate and then to handle it if it happens again in the future?
You know, something else that she said to Holly Rowe as well is, you know, she didn't want to answer anger or angry words with anger of her own. I think that's a very adult and grown-up thing
it
to
was.
Do and a great example for all.
She was very mature.
Now, Holly Rowe also reported that BYU made changes to their fan code of conduct, including fans moved off the baseline at volleyball matches. But Rachel's approach, just to find a way to learn to move forward, is very impressive. Out of Florida timeout. Gators get a point, much needed after they had fallen behind by four. Markova with the kill.
And Markova again hitting with that crazy range, very sharp angle, high contact point. Tough to stop.
Serve has been an issue. See if she can get this one in. She can. Stanford handles it. Markova with the dig. Stuckey to Beeson. Sophia Victoria into the match for Florida. She's the one who helped it over, but then Stanford ends up getting the point, and they're back up by four here in the second.
I feel like Florida's gone away from their middle attacker. Gabby Essex was unstoppable in the first set, and they've had opportunities to get her the ball, and they haven't. I think they need to go back to that.
Service error for Miner. Point for Florida. Florida. 19-16, set two. Set one was won by Stanford, 31-29. Good serve by McKissick. Stuckey sets it to Kelly in the middle.
And there's that middle attack that was so good in the first set. Don't go away from that when that's working. And both the middle attackers for Florida are high percentage attackers. Anytime you run that middle, it frees up the outside, so you don't want to go away from that.
Timeout called by Stanford. Their first timeout here of the second set. Cardinal are on top by two. So as they cool off and talk things over, I can tell you about our week one SEC lineup this Saturday on SEC Network and also on SEC Network Plus. First game starts at noon Eastern time. Sixth-ranked Texas A&M will host Sam Houston. It will continue on through the evening, highlighted by number one Alabama taking on Utah State at 7:30 Eastern time. Every game is also available on the ESPN app, so you can watch anywhere. Well, I would be remiss if I did not pay tribute and say congratulations to the gold medalists who are among us here in this match here today. The U21 team that won Pan American gold in Mexico, coached by Dan Fisher, the Pittsburgh head coach. Four members of Team USA on the court here tonight.
Three for Florida, Alexis Stuckey. Merritt Beeson was actually the MVP. Bree Kelly out of the middle for Florida. And then Elia Rubin, the representative from Stanford.
So congratulations to Beeson and Stuckey and Kelly. And on the other side of the net, Elia Rubin. Out of the Stanford timeout, here is McKissick to serve again. That's a good one to draw up coming out of the timeout, isn't it? Let's find Kendall Kipp.
Fastball to the left pin. They look like they might set Vicini on that ball, and that held the middle blocker defensively for Florida.
Baird to serve. 12th kill of the night for Kipp. Free ball for Stanford. And a point for the Cardinal.
Kendall Kipp is heating up, and Stanford really relies on her a lot for offense. I mean, between she and Katie Baird, they go back and forth in terms of leading the team in kills.
Right now it's Kipp, 13 kills, a team high on a team high 27 swings, and a service error on Stanford. Much need a point for Florida late here in set number two.
Looks like Stanford's trying to serve that area five straight down the line from the right side and missing it long pretty consistently.
Beeson to serve. Miner sets it back, and that one's going to be off the mark. Attack error on Stanford. Give Florida another point, and here come the Gators.
First set, it was Stanford that made the big push at the end. This time, Florida's doing the same.
That one is long, and another point for the Gators.
Cammie Miner has three hitters available. She can run that middle.
Three
good first contact.
Sorry, Holly, 3-0 run right now. Oh, and a service error for Beeson, who otherwise has had a pretty strong service night.
Sammy Francis back in the game for Stanford in the middle.
Ogilvy back to serve. Kelly off balance, can't clear the net. Stanford now 2 points away from taking set two, and Florida will use their final timeout.
Stanford tends to serve the ball very deep in the court, but that time Ogilvy going short, kind of messing up the rhythm of Florida's offense.
Well, you mentioned one night it could be Katie Baird, the next night it could be Kendall Kipp. Right now, they're both making big contributions. Baird with 7 kills, but Kipp with 13 kills to lead all players here in Gainesville.
Not only is she doing it from the front row, she's also getting it done with her serve. Some tough service pressure in the first set kept her team in that match.
So Kipp came in off to a great start this season in the two victories in Nashville for Stanford. Averaged nearly 4 kills a set, hit 370. Remember, she had 340 last year. Kevin Hambley just put it very simply, best opposite that I've seen. And just the way that she's been working with her center, Cammie Miner, that they are better, you would assume, with a little bit more time together after Miner's freshman year, they are better already in the early going this year than where they were last year.
I feel like every year you add to that relationship in terms of the tools
connection
that you create,
gets
the
stronger,
connection,
yeah.
The trust, too.
Yes.
When you work with somebody, you create that trust, and you know what they're going to do in certain situations.
Stanford 2 points away from taking set two. Ogilvy back to serve. And it's a service error. That is the 9th service error for Stanford.
And the second time, I believe, after a timeout that Stanford missed their serve. Talk about icing the server, that's always a good move. Taking a timeout.
Trinity Adams. Good block. Markova. Kelly there as well.
The biggest block on the court, and Stanford goes right at them. I would love to see them get the ball back to Sammy Francis in the middle. Offensively, Stanford's gone away, and they're relying heavily on Kendall Kipp, and it becomes predictable.
So Kelly and Markova sharing that block, and Stanford will call a timeout. 23-22 Cardinal here in the second set. Florida picked second in the SEC preseason poll behind Kentucky.
Stanford picked second behind Washington in the preseason Pac-12 poll. You know, I mean, preseason polls are kind of tough. You know, you don't know what's going to happen, but Washington very strong in the Pac-12. I think both these teams will do extremely well in conference.
Well, you take a look at, well, Washington has so much talent back, experienced players back from their back-to-back Pac-12 championship team. So how do you get ready for Pac-12 play? You play a schedule like this if you're Stanford. Tonight starts a stretch of six straight against teams in the top 25. Their home opener at Maples is against number one Texas on Sunday. Then they have Penn State, then Minnesota in Minneapolis, second-ranked Nebraska in Lincoln. Then they go back home for third-ranked Louisville, all before their Pac-12 opener against Cal on September 21st.
And before they even start school. They don't even start school till the end of September. So that's nice. They have all that travel. They're getting it out of the way. But quite a challenging upcoming schedule, a big test for the Stanford team.
Both teams have used their timeouts here in set two. Adams to serve. Markova drops it in. Stanford keeps it alive. Great point. Stanford has a set point.
Elia Rubin, 13 in black, has done such a nice job hitting that ball inside the block, sharp angle for Stanford.
Stanford didn't have a set point until it was 30-29 in set one. They get a set point here in set two. Niner calls for it. Stuckey sets it. Good diving play to keep it alive by Kip. Dropped in beautifully. Crafty move by the freshman, Rubin, to get the kill. And Stanford takes set two.
Elia Rubin, the California Gatorade Player of the Year, knows how to win, finishing that last point for Stanford with the tip to the middle.
Teams will change ends. There will be a brief intermission here before we get to set three. And before we take a break, Kevin Hambley, the Stanford head coach, he's got the headset on. Thumbs up, Kevin. You hear us okay? Yeah, we got you. Well, you asked the question, can we compete? What did you think about your compete level in these first two sets?
I think especially the first set when we were down, you know, and we had to battle back, and they had us to get their backs against the wall, and they had a couple of match point swings. We saw us execute. I think we can still execute at a higher level. We can pass at a higher level. There's a lot of things we can get better at, but I really like the grit that we showed in that. It's not easy when the whole crowd, this place, as you guys heard, you guys were here, it was going crazy, and the students were going nuts, and we had to fight through that. It was really a good moment for us to fight through, for sure.
You fought off seven set points by our count, so well done in that first set. Kevin, thanks for the time. We appreciate it.
That was easy. Thanks.
Cardinal head coach Kevin Hambley in the sixth season. His team up 2-0, heading to set three here in Gainesville. Up 2-0 here in Gainesville. Last year, Stanford knocked off Florida in a matchup of top 20 teams. Stanford's first match in front of fans at Maples since 2019. Can they do it here on the road in Gainesville tonight? Take a look at the numbers, and the blocks have really stood out here tonight for Stanford.
Yeah, I think Stanford's definitely picked up their defensive at the net especially, but Florida's gone away from their middle attackers who had great first set, and I think Florida needs to go back to that so they can hit at a higher clip. I think that's what kept them in that first set.
Yeah, Gabby Essex had 5 kills in that first set. She didn't have a kill in set two. That's one name that jumps out. Merritt Beeson leading the way along with Bree Kelly. Kelly's been good. 8 kills each for Beeson and for Kelly. And on the other end, we talked about Kendall Kipp with the 13 kills to pace the Cardinal. Stanford in that set hit 306. They're hitting 316 for the match, as you just saw. Florida was held to 061 in that second set, now hitting 224 for the match.
I think Stanford needs to be careful. They don't want to become one-dimensional. You don't want to be all Kendall Kipp. They've got the weapons to use. They should use them. That ball set a little bit low to Vicini in the middle, but I like the idea of trying to get the middle going. But Sammy Francis disappeared in the second set because she wasn't getting the sets.
You didn't have to read between the lines of what Kevin Hambly told us at the end of that second set. Love to compete, especially in that first set, fighting off all those set points. But there's plenty that he thinks his team can clean up, and that's what you would expect in August here. We are still in the last week of August.
And that's why they like these preseason tests, to figure those things out now.
Katie Baird to serve. One thing that they'll love to clean up. This is a very good serving team perennially, but it hasn't clicked at all times here tonight. 10 service errors for Stanford.
And I'm wondering if that late shift by the passers from Florida is affecting the servers of Stanford.
That's an ace for McKissick.
McKissick finds the coffin corner ace. Her older sister got in the transfer portal and is now the starting setter at UCLA.
Maddie, setter for Georgia Tech the last four seasons. Georgia Tech, just a dynamic team to watch. Was in that Louisville regional with Florida.
Attack here.
Last December. Florida. Ohio State, Louisville, Florida, and Georgia Tech in that regional. First time that four female head coaches had all been at one regional. Historic matchup there at Freedom Hall. Off hands and out of play, and a point for Stanford.
Stanford tried to get the ball to Vicini a couple times, didn't work. Go back to Kipp, but try and get your other hitters involved. Now Sammy Francis in the front row for Stanford. Let's see if they can get her some offense. When you set the ball to your middle attackers, it helps get their defense going as well.
Oh, good block. Victoria and Kelly at the net for the Gators.
Sophia Victoria, number four in white. Now on that left side pin for Florida. Great left-hand turn, pressing that ball back into the court for the Florida block.
Five blocks for the Gators tonight. Oh, big swing. Nothing Victoria can do with that as the freshman, Elia Rubin, gets another kill.
Rubin is hitting with really nice range in that sharp angle. We've seen her do it consistently.
Seven kills for Rubin, hitting .333 tonight. Another service error for the Cardinal.
That ball just long. Kendall Kipp, Stanford's strongest server. Off the line, that's a good thing for Florida.
That's 11. I do believe that Kevin Hambly is checking. Yeah, where's the service error line? Oh, 11, yeah, that's. Oh.
Huge front line right now for Florida. Kelly Markova and Stuckey.
Oh, and Stanford tried to go around that size and missed the mark, so it's a point for the Gators.
McKissick, the libero from Florida, was all over it regardless.
It's funny, you just talked about the size in the front line and you mentioned Stuckey. That's the setter who's up front, who brings that size at 6'2". The service error for the Gators, that's their sixth. Rubin puts it in play. Good block. Florida thought about celebrating. Now they can celebrate, but it was, well, they say it was off the mark. Maybe a little bit of debate if it was off hands, and I do think that a challenge is going to be issued here by Stanford.
Kevin.
And Kevin Hambley has the green card in hand. He's still keeping it close to the chest. I don't know if he's officially called for it.
The first reaction from the line judge in that corner was that there was a touch, and the up ref overruled it.
So Stanford will officially challenge that there was a touch.
Early in that rally, Florida blocked Stanford straight down, and Sammy Francis made a fantastic cover play. This is the last swing in transition. I do not see any finger movement. Usually you see those fingers move.
Blow it up a little bit here. Looks like it's through the hands of Stuckey. As she's coming down.
I don't see any finger movement.
Let's magnify it even more. This is ultra magnification technology we're unleashing
That's
on you right here,
impressive.
Apparently. Yes. We call this fingerprint zoom.
I say no touch.
So a reminder, each team is allowed two challenges. If the challenge is successful, you get to keep the challenge. If it's unsuccessful, you lose that challenge. If we go to a fifth set, each team will get an additional challenge, but you can never have more than two challenges in hand in a match, and this is what they can look for here. And you saw clearly that Stanford is challenging that it was touched at the net.
I think it's nice, the adjustment to that rule where you're only allowed two, so you're not using it as a tool to slow things down.
Challenge was unsuccessful. Call is confirmed. So Stanford with one challenge remaining. Florida has yet to use a challenge, and Bree Kelly will go back to serve. Good block, mark him up.
That's where I want to see Stanford go to Sammy Francis. She's in the front row, we've gone away from her. You do not want to lose that connection, that rhythm with the game.
They go to Francis here. Everyone looking for it, and Florida can't grab it. Eason grabbed the referee's ladder to try to slow down.
Florida had a good touch on it, but finally they got Francis a kill for Stanford.
Francis will head to the bench. Bevan will head back to serve for the Cardinal. Stuckey, the 6-2 setter hangs in the air and drops down the kill.
Well, Stanford forgot their job. You always call out who the hitters are and who is in the front row, and Stanford fell asleep on that one. 6'2", open net. McKenna Vicini needs to have her hands up as a blocker in the middle.
Service error for Stuckey. Point for Stanford.
I'd like to see Florida go back to Gabby Essex in the middle if they get the pass they want.
Minor serves for the Cardinal. They go to Essex. That was there in set one. We didn't see it in set two. It's back in set three.
Use that all the time. Perfect execution. It starts with a good pass. Stuckey feeds Essex high and quick, and the result is a Florida Gator kill.
Sixth of the night for Essex. Had six kills last time out against Virginia. Markova would love to have that one back. An attack error into the net. Shakes her head, and now we'll head off. You do get the sense, though, the door is open here for Florida. You can look at the scoreboard, see they've been up by as much as five, up by four right now. Stanford not as sharp, it would appear, here in this third set. Can Florida take advantage and get back into this match, down 2-0? And a Pringle to serve. Pringle with the dig, but it's out of play, and a point for the Gators.
I think Stanford could do a better job getting all their hitters involved. I said earlier they're becoming a little one-dimensional with Kendall Kipp.
Good serve by McKissick. Ogilvie got there. Oh, nice reaction and adjustment by Vicini to get the point.
Good eye work. She saw the shot coming and swats it back. Look at that hand.
On her way
it.
Down.
Yeah, throws it back. Good eye work.
That's her fourth kill. Ogilvie. Stuckey to Victoria. First kill of the night for Sophia Victoria.
Alexis Stuckey isolates her hitter on the left side pin, and Sophia Victoria is the recipient of that sweet set from the freshman setter.
31 assists for Stuckey, 31 for the Stanford setter, Miner. And a point for Stanford.
Elia Rubin finding a way. We've seen her chisel that sharp angle that time flat off the hands. Learning on the job. Kevin Hambley's been really impressed by the height of contact and the way she's learning the game.
Stuckey tries Victoria again. Stuckey tries to kill again, and it goes up off the face of Kip. Point Florida.
Alexis Stuckey did not call her own number at all in the first two sets, but we've seen two kills in this third set for Florida. She sees that ball tight, goes up, nice turn from the right side. That's when it helps to be a big setter, 6'2", having that range to hit that ball.
Two kills, four digs, a block, 31 assists. And even though we're very close to a media timeout, Stanford doesn't want to wait. Kevin Hambley takes the timeout for the Cardinal. His team down by five in the third. For another year, Alyssa Lang, Andrea Carter, they take you inside the world of SEC sports. They've got the laid-back interviews, lots of laughs, and Alyssa's signature passion for finding the best food the SEC has to offer. 1 hour season premiere tomorrow at 7 Eastern here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Just a heads up for Alyssa, Holly found a terrific taco place here today. And Holly's from California, so she knows good tacos. So you may want to send a DM off to Alyssa just to let her know what to check out here in Gainesville.
I will do that. I love food, too.
Oh, good job. McKissick got there to save it. Beeson calls her off. And contact with the net by Florida, I do believe, and it's going to be a point for Stanford.
The blocker cannot block the setter when she's trying to set the ball, and that's what happened on that tight pass.
So Stanford trying to get their personnel squared away here. Mary Wise's team, we talked about the schedule ahead for Stanford. Well, Florida will be at Minnesota on Sunday. They've got Florida State coming up September 13th. And September 16th, they have the defending national champions, Wisconsin, at the Kohl Center, where there'll be, oh, I don't know, 17,000 Wisconsin fans. Florida calls a timeout here. So Stanford picks up a couple of points after the timeout to bring it within three. They are up 2-0 here in this best of five.
I've been really impressed with the freshman setter for Florida, Alexis Stuckey. She's what they call a coach's kid. She grew up in the gym, but her mom was a standout player at Wyoming, then went on to coach at Kansas as an assistant, and then went back as the head coach for Wyoming. So Alexis Stuckey grew up in a gym watching her mom learning from her mom, but you know what else she did? She's the Wyoming 9-time 4-H horse champion as well.
Really?
So she was busy. Not only was she chasing a volleyball around, she was riding horses.
That's some talent right there, and she has some talent on the volleyball court, as we've seen here today. I mean, against Virginia last time out, 33 assists, 5 aces, 3 digs. She's got a similar stat line here today, 31 assists, 4 digs. She's got the 2 kills. She's already picked up the first SEC Freshman of the Week award, co-freshman of the week, to be exact, this week, and she's done nothing to hurt her candidacy for back-to-back titles so far, the way she's played, and try to keep Florida going in this match, but they are down 2-0 to the Cardinal. Although they're up here, Albert, I think, got a little tired out from that wild first set. So, yeah, just trying to get the energy back. First set was 31-29. Stanford fought off 7 set points. There's Rubin. Another service error. That's 12 for the Cardinal.
And I think that's 3 after a timeout.
We haven't kept that stat. I don't doubt you, but I guarantee you that the Stanford bench is going to, they're going to go through this and say, when we come out of the timeout, please get that serve in.
Please.
I'm not asking for much.
Katie Baird that time terminates that ball down the line.
Kelly will check out. Essex is on.
Here's a rotation for Florida. Setter for Stuckey's front row. I heard Vicini for Stanford say Setter's up. She's got to be aware of that, as does Baird. Love to see Florida go to Gabby Essex in the middle.
They go to Markova.
That ball did not get over.
4 hits, so it's a point for Stanford. So the Cardinal had looked pretty flat here in this third set. They were down 14-9, but they are chipping away. But they have not helped themselves at all from the service line tonight.
Stanford's known as one of the best serving teams in the country, and when it's not there, it's a lot of errors because you're trying to go aggressive.
Stuckey back to serve for the Gators. That misses. Point for Florida.
Stanford team telling their coach to challenge. They saw a touch.
And the card is out. And Kevin Hambley will use his second challenge.
I'm not so sure I saw a touch. I'm looking forward to seeing the replay.
Like you said, his players seem pretty convinced.
That pinky making me nervous. Looks like it might have caught some fingers
there.
Yeah,
but when you say looks like and might, that's not convincing enough.
Good point.
To overturn it. You're hedging a little bit, Holly, and I don't blame you because I don't see anything moving there. The ball certainly is close.
Especially that left-hand pinky really sticking out. You'd think it would move if it was touching.
Now, they do have access to our replay looks. They also have their own looks at net level that we will not be able to see, but they have at their disposal. So they could be seeing something a little bit more definitive than what you see right there. I don't think there's enough that we have seen.
I agree. I actually had a really good angle on it the first time.
Okay, just a reminder of the challenge rule.
So if Kevin Hambley does not win this challenge, he's out of challenges.
Out of challenges unless we go to a fifth set, and then Stanford will be given one challenge for the fifth set. Talking with Mike Johnson, first-year assistant, former Notre Dame head coach, now on Stanford staff.
Kevin Hambly talked about his coaching staff, Alex Dunphy and Mike Johnson, both with tons of coaching experience, and that really helps him do his job. They can take care of a lot of the things that he's had to do in the past.
Stanford is 0-2 on challenges, so that green challenge card can be put away for Stanford. That's the risk on the touch. It is so hard to tell sometimes if there's been a touch. You're going by something that you thought you heard or what your team is telling you. No doubt what happened there. That's a kill for Stanford.
That time, Katie Baird finds that corner, deep corner swing. Stanford needs some stops defensively, and Essex and Beeson in the front row with Markova from Florida.
That serve catches the tape, makes it over, and there is Essex.
7 kills off 13 swings. Essex has been unstoppable for Florida.
Markova back to serve for the Gators. Back up by 4. Service error for Florida. That's their 8th. Compare that with 13 service errors for Stanford. Katie Baird back to serve for the Cardinal. That one wasn't close. You talked about how good historically Stanford is serving. It has been a great asset to them and their success. Back-to-back national championships just a couple years ago. It's a great weapon for them, but if it's not on, that's going to keep teams in the match, and you're giving away a lot of points.
Correct. And when it's not working, you have to dial it back and serve smart.
That's not how Florida would have drawn it up. But it's effective nonetheless. Good saves by both teams, and Beeson with about a 15-mile-per-hour kill.
Well, Stuckey pulled that ball off the net. Beeson was coming in for a nice in-system play, but good hand contact by number 13, Merritt Beeson. Drops for Florida.
Timeout called by Stanford, so they're out of challenges, and now they are out of timeouts here in set 2 with Florida up by 5. A reminder of our Week 1 SEC lineup this Saturday on the SEC Network and also on SEC Network Plus. Game 1 starts noon Eastern. 6th-ranked Texas A&M and Sam Houston. It'll continue through the day into the night. Capped by number 1 Alabama facing Utah State. That's at 7:30 Eastern time. Every game also available on the ESPN app, so you can watch wherever you may be.
Right now, in this current set, Stanford hitting .077 compared to Florida's .294. For the match, Stanford 257, Florida at 237. So their numbers have come down. Both teams were over 300 after the first set.
Yeah, in fact, Florida out-hit Stanford in that first set, 349 to 326. Stanford's been a plus 300 in each of the first two sets, and you just pointed out they're sub-100 here in this set. So can Florida take advantage? Stanford's had the service errors, not hitting at a good number. Florida has felt like they've been in control of this third set from the start as they try to get back into this match, and McKissick will try to keep it going at the service line. Good block and a point for the Gators. The defense is strong for Florida.
I'll tell you, Florida worked hard on their blocking formation and their communication. Watch Bree Kelly go way over the net for Florida, closing that seam. They start inside to stop that particular set.
Largest lead of the night for the Gators, on top by six, and a chance here to add to it. That one is out. Another point for the Gators.
Florida in a nice rhythm defensively, touching everything.
4-0 run for the Gators. McKissick, the most experienced Gator, the junior, serves it. Oh, another block. Bree Kelly at the net. The Florida defense is on point right now.
Bree Kelly is so good laterally, side to side, closing that block. And I'll tell you, when we watched them practice earlier, Florida worked a lot on their communication, closing that block, where they wanted to start on each particular player, and it's paying off for Florida right now.
Gators had 4 blocks combined in the first 2 sets. They have 4 blocks in this set. Make it 5.
Bree Kelly in on the last 3. Pretty impressive for Florida, and I feel like the Gators have new life. Set point Gators.
Set point for the Gators.
Stanford trying to find some momentum of their own. Vicini, number 14 in black, with a block. But Stanford in a big hole in this third set.
Sophia Victoria makes it an emphatic yes with the kill. First time this year, Stanford has dropped a set. Florida on the comeback trail here in Gainesville. Now down 2-1, heading to set 4 next. Stanford pulled that one out, and they are back into it now. Florida, a one-sided win in set number 3. Take a look at through 3 sets, but when you break it down and look at the numbers in that third set, it just shows you that all the momentum's with Florida right now.
And it was all about the defense, the blocking of Bree Kelly. 3 blocks in a row to finish out that third set. Offensive numbers for Florida up, Stanford's offensive numbers down. We talked about the Gator way with Coach Mary Wise. I'll tell you, culture is a big thing for her. Expressing gratitude, being grateful for their opportunities, being other-oriented, so caring about others, and then team first. The other thing I like at the end, beginner's mindset, always learning, trying to get better every single day. And I'll tell you, people talk about Mary Wise as a coach and what she leaves as her legacy, and I'll tell you, it's people first in this volleyball program. And I think that's really special.
Well, you go through that checklist and they'll get you the number 1 on the active wins list and 5th on the Division I all-time wins list. Well, yeah, I'm getting hungry because I think if that last set is any indication, we could be here a while because Florida dominated that set. They had 3 attack errors in that set. Stanford had 11 attack errors in that third set. Miscommunication, but it works out just fine for the Gators. Victoria's made an impact off the bench here for the Gators tonight.
She certainly has, sparking that L2 position, that second outside attacker for Florida. She's having a big match so far.
3 kills on 7 swings for the junior from Puerto Rico. That one will drop in, the kill for Francis.
Well, that's something that just disappeared for the second and third set, not getting the ball to Sammy Francis. With her length, she can be a big scorer for Stanford in the middle. They need to find a way to get her the ball.
Kelly was blocked. Beeson stopped. But then Beeson comes back to get the block at the net for Florida.
Florida has made a blocking adjustment on Elia Rubin and scooted that block in to take that sharp angle away from her, and it pays off.
Well, I think it was Kelly, not Beeson. Yeah, I think Bree Kelly should get contact. Now they'll share it with Beeson, but good job those two teaming up.
And a touch. Sammy Francis back-to-back kills for Stanford. That's a good sign. Get another attacker involved besides Kip and Baird.
6'6 sophomore from San Diego. Now with 8 kills.
Serving woes continue for Stanford.
That's 15 service errors for the Cardinal. Florida took advantage of the Stanford mistakes in the third set. You can't blame the Gators for being put on their heels a little bit after having the 7 set points in set one and losing that set 31-29. They battled in set two, but they didn't hit at a very high percentage. Third set, they hit at 250. Their defense was good. Stanford made mistakes, and as a result, Florida's back in this match now, down 2-1. Good digs on both ends. Bilardi for Stanford, McKissick for the Gators. Barkala, no digging that swing, lot on it.
Superb defense both sides of the net, but the rangy Markova out of Russia able to finish that rally. Look at her arm, just the length and the whip on it. 22 in white with the kill.
That's her 8th on 23 swings.
Kip stepped on the 3-meter line.
Back row attack.
Violation, and the point goes to Florida.
So the violation on the swing from the back row will give the point to the Gators. Service errors, hitting errors. Another miss on the swing.
No more challenges. Players look at their coach, but no more challenges for Stanford unless we get to a fifth set.
Well, we talked to Kevin Hamley at the end of the second set because he had discussed wanting to see how his team could compete, what their compete level would be. It was really good in set one. They battled in set two. But now they need to answer the challenge in set three. Point for Florida. Hambley's really upset because one of the line judges said there was a touch, but the R1 and the R2 disagree.
I didn't see a touch.
Again, Stanford is out of challenges. The protest as he takes a look over at the line judge. Now there's frustration, certainly right now. There's nothing you can do about it when it comes to challenging it, so you have to play through it. So let's take you back one play. Well, it looks like maybe the left hand is stuck. The left finger came back a little bit. That looked, on that replay, like perhaps there was a touch, but again, R1 and R2 didn't call it, so it was a point for Florida. For Essex, good adjustment just to get it over the net. And then off hands out of play, point for Stanford.
Essex saved that ball. Set was a little bit low, and Stanford gets an opportunity to score with their defense.
Good serve, good save, good swing.
She gets on top of that ball so quick. You don't think it's coming, and then there it is.
And Markova showing the love, kissing the red hair of Stuckey at the end of that play.
Well, a one-arm diving dig set that pops up perfectly for Markova, and she pays her off with that.
Let's take you back. This is how you celebrate.
Much love. I love it. You got to love up your setters. That's important.
Right, good diving play. Save it for the Gators. That's long, and Stanford's got the point.
Point to Stanford.
Stanford working to involve other hitters. That time, Vicini gets the attack. Point for the Gators. Great work on both sides. It ends with a point for Essex. Extended rally. Gabby Essex, number 10 in white, saw that little off-speed shot coming. Watch her press back, throwing that half-speed ball down.
Worked out really well. Bump set beautifully by Rubin, right on the money for the kill.
Elia Rubin had a huge block in front of her. It looked like the blockers had the advantage, but she found a way to get that ball down the line.
Rubin now with 9 kills. That's an ace.
Timely ace. I feel like it's been a long time since we've said Stanford ace. And that was probably since Kendall Kipp in that first set.
You are correct. They had 2 aces in the first set. That is their first ace since set one.
Gabby Essex.
That's something you talked about, Holly. Getting Gabby Essex back involved in this match, because she was a big part of set one. And she's been a big part of this comeback.
She has, and as going back to her and having that confidence really helps her defense too. So get her the ball. She's been unstoppable as an offensive weapon for Florida.
8 kills, hitting .438, and has a couple of blocks. That one will drop in. It's a point for Stanford.
Stanford getting all their hitters involved, doing a better job of it. It started with Sammy Francis, even though she got blocked. They established her as a weapon.
On the overpass, Stanford takes advantage of a Florida mistake to get the point.
Very aggressive serve from Kipp gets them out of system. Easy throw down for Elia Rubin at the net for Stanford.
Cardinal have come back to tie it at 10. Beeson with a great kill.
Merritt Beeson just elevated. Nice cross-court deep kill for Florida.
Team high 11 kills for Beeson.
How about Stuckey with that bump set on a dime? Great location and transition.
Beeson back to serve. That one one is long, a hitting error for the freshman Reuben, Point Florida.
Stanford out of system. That was basically a one option ball. And to make sure to push that pass up to the net so setter Cammie Miner has some other options.
Beeson goes with a short serve. Swing from the back. Touch point for Stanford.
Kendall Kipp coming out of the back row for the kill. Stanford hitting 185 in this fourth set compared to Florida's 234.
It's 185 for the match. They're hitting 087 in this set, the Cardinal. Oh, there's the defense though for Stanford. That's when they've been at their best. They get the block.
Cammie Miner, the smallest blocker on the court, sets this up. She's there with her feet, big press, and then Sammy Francis getting there for the assist.
That's the first block of this set for Stanford. 11 for the match and an ace. Well, the Cardinal have stuck with the aggressive serve. Even though they have piled up those service errors, they haven't taken their foot off the gas, it would appear, when it comes to the serve.
You're right, and now it's starting to pay off.
Forcing a timeout to be called by Florida. We'll take the timeout as well. Stanford, after falling behind 9-6, up by one here in set four. Minor college football season is here. Opening night of college football on the SEC Network is this Thursday, 7 Eastern time. Tennessee and Ball State in Knoxville here on the SEC Network and also on the ESPN app. Stanford fought off 7 set points to take set 1, 31-29. They won set 2 by 3, 25-22. All Florida in the third set. Now Stanford has taken a lead in the fourth, and this has been a theme all night. Out of a timeout, a service error.
Do we have a new stat box?
We'll have to build one, chagrin of the Cardinal. That's 16 service errors, and by your count, 4 out of timeouts tonight.
There's lots of serving rules when you grow up playing the sport of volleyball. One is don't miss at match point, and the other one is don't miss after a timeout.
So, pardon the pun, a cardinal sin was committed.
Sammy Francis right there for Stanford. Good choice by Cammie Miner.
Stanford jumped out to a 2-0 lead by using that block in the defense and getting the points at the net. Francis delivering. One's in on the serve. Stuckey. Bounced around. No one will get there. And it's another point for the Cardinal. Up by 2 now in the 4th.
A serve that I haven't seen a lot of all night. I thought Ogilvy might have had one short serve. But a short serve can be really disruptive because it interferes with offensive routes. And I'd like to see more short serving, especially when you're serving the ball long.
Offhand Bilardi, who's serving for Stanford, kept it going. That one is deflected. A kill for Baird. That's 12 on the night for Baird.
Kelly Bilardi able to stay in another rotation. That's 2 points off of her serve. As a server, you want to earn points in your rotation when you're on the service line.
Service error for Stanford. That's 17.
This is a tough rotation for Stanford. Cammie Miner's in the front row, and they've got 2 setters front row, but they will use Kendall Kipp out of the back row.
Well, when Miner does that, she'll take care of it herself. Gets the kill.
Good first contact allows Cammie Miner to attack that ball. Katie Baird puts it right in her hand.
Miner heads back to serve with Stanford up by 3. Blocked, and it looked like it was just wide. It was out, so the point goes to Florida.
Kipp and Vicini for Stanford, well-formed block. Just need to turn their hands back into the court a little bit more.
Good serve by Stuckey. Miner backpedals to set it. And a block by Florida. Essex and Markova team up for the Gators.
Beautiful block by the Gators on the left side.
Each team with 12 team blocks tonight. That one sails. Good choice by Stanford to let it float out of play. So a service error for Florida. Now Katie Baird will come out, and Anna Pringle, the freshman, will come back in.
Florida has three good offensive options. Gabby Essex in the front row. You see a big shift with the serve receive of Florida.
There's Essex with another kill. Nine for Gabby Essex. Her career high was six.
Fun
so she keeps
her.
Adding to it.
Yeah, she just, you can just feel her energy. She's got a strong motor, working hard, making herself available to hit that ball.
Essex had a total of 29 kills in 29 sets last year. And have a lot more playing time this year. Oh, good dig there by Kanan. And then blocked back at the net by Stanford. Point Cardinal.
Kip all over that, making her presence felt defensively at the net.
Ogilvie back to serve. Stanford trying to get to 20. Essex says, not yet.
I love the confidence of Stuckey and Gabby Essex going back to her. Okay, they blocked her once. Easy cover play going right back at her. That shows so much confidence in her middle attacker.
Essex into double figures in kills for the first time in her career, hitting at 474 tonight. Off hands, Stuckey to McKissick. To Beeson. Had to slam on the brick so she didn't run into the net. A kill for Beeson. She adds to her team high total now with 12. And Stanford will take a timeout. We're even at 19.
Loving the back and forth battle. And then point scoring as well with their defense. That time it looked like Stanford had an opportunity to score with their block, but Beeson found a way.
Big crowd here tonight, 3,814. They got here early. They were really loud in that first set. The play of Stanford at the end of that first set and into the second set quieted them down a bit. But a really strong third set. Florida ran right by Stanford 25-16, and now they've battled back to make it a 19-19 set four. And Gabby Essex has been in the middle of the highlights for Florida tonight.
She certainly has. Quick arm through the seam. Look at the high contact point there. But also getting it done. Three blocks, 10 kills, hitting 474 for Florida. Wow. Love the fire. Love the connection with she and Stuckey, the setter.
So the Gators and the Cardinal tied at 19 here in the fourth. A Florida win. We will head to a decisive fifth set. Stuckey with 42 assists, six digs on the night. Cammie Miner not to be outdone, 41 assists, seven digs. For the Cardinal. McKissick to serve for Florida. Well, Miner had to make an adjustment to make a pretty good set to Francis, who got the kill.
A really good, and I like the decision to go to Sammy Francis. At 6 foot six, she's got that range. Just gets on top of it, throws it down to the middle of the court.
So the Cardinal, the first team to 20 here in the fourth. And now we're tied at 20. 18 service errors for Stanford.
This is like the red zone in football. I mean, you have to be executing at a very high level.
Good serve by Beeson. Back row attack goes long.
I would have loved to see that ball go back to Sammy Francis. I think everybody thinks it's going to Kip on that play.
Kip with 12 errors on the attack tonight. There is Francis. Kelly kept it alive for Beeson. Now Victoria will set it for the freshman. Ruben has it blocked. Victoria winds and connects.
The way the defense for Florida is moving, getting touches, and then transitioning back, attacking back at Stanford, I'm really impressed at the level of execution.
3-0 run for Florida forces a Stanford timeout. The Gators 3 points away from forcing a fifth set. Great fight by Mary Wise's team, down 2-0. Came back and controlled that third set. And now building some momentum late here in set number 4. Stanford out of timeouts. Reminder, Stanford's out of challenges. We are late in this fourth set. We go to a fifth set. Stanford will get a challenge back. But after set 2, didn't look like we were going to get to a fourth set, let alone a fifth set.
You're right, but Florida's, I feel like they've all night long have been never say die. I mean, we see them diving into these barriers and going after every ball. The energy is there, and I feel like they've got the pieces of the puzzle to be really remarkable this season.
It's been good balance, too. Beeson with 12 kills, Essex with 10 kills, Markova with 10 kills, Kelly with 8, Victoria Spark off the bench with the 4. Stuckey running the show at the center position. They've kept the smiles, the energy, the fun up all night long. Can they get to a fifth set is the question. Beeson to serve. Targeted the freshman, Ruben, who couldn't handle the serve, and it's 23-20.
Elia Ruben, yes, she is a freshman. Yes, this is a bigger stage, but she's got a great platform, usually very solid in her first contact, not having her best match tonight in terms of serve-receive.
Does Beeson look for her again? She does. Short serve. Francis finds the opening and gets the kill.
Well-delivered ball that time, high enough that she can go over the block. These are the challenges Kevin Hamley was talking about. Backs against the wall, how do we respond? We saw it at the end of the first set. Can they do it again?
Florida crowd making some noise. Ruben, good serve. Stuckey back set. Kelly, the block by Stanford. Francis and Barrett at the net.
Both hands, actually all 4 hands of the Stanford block over the net early, ready to block that ball.
Timeout called by the Gators.
Watch the handwork. Both players pressing that one. Katie Baird, number 22 in black, gets most of it for Stanford.
Fourteen blocks on the night for the Cardinal, 12 for Florida. Timeout called by the Gators. That's their final timeout.
Stanford with a slight advantage in the blocking category, 14-12.
All right, so out of this timeout, if you're Stanford with the serve, you know it's been a struggle. Coming out of timeouts all night long.
Yep.
So what's the mindset? Do you stay aggressive with the serve? Do you play it safe? Who are you targeting?
You aggressively serve the ball in. That's what you do.
You serve aggressively, but in a conservative manner? Is that what you're trying to
Yeah, just a little bit of deceleration, just a little bit.
All right, you're calling for taking a little something off, getting something in, because that has been a problem, especially out of several timeouts.
And Stanford likes to serve that 5-6 area, maybe more of a seam. I'd love a short serve, too. I mean, if you look at the serve receive of Florida, there's a lot of cross-court short open. And it would disrupt the path of Stuckey coming in to set the ball.
So you see what Rubin is looking at as she gets ready to serve. Excellent serve. Excellent save. Florida stays in the point for the moment. Free ball for Stanford. Good block. Point Florida. Set point Gators.
Stanford trying to go to Sammy Francis on the right side. Good defensive block by Florida. Stanford can't cover it. Right now, backs against the wall.
Well, we saw this in set one when Florida led 24-22 in set one, and Stanford ended up winning that set, so it is not over yet.
Markova pretty impressive on that last swing. I think she might have given her setter another kiss. Look at the range inside the left hand of Sammy Francis, and she's got the leg to get on top of that and drive it down for Florida.
Will we have a set five? To quote the Florida crowd, yes. We are going five here in this top 15 showdown. The Gators and Cardinal next. Of seven set points to take set one. They won set two. Florida cruised in set three. And then in set four, the Gators won by three, setting up a decisive fifth set. Will play to 15. You have to win by two as you take a look at the numbers through four sets. And after a very hot start, Stanford has cooled off with the hitting, and Florida has surpassed the Cardinal when it comes to hitting percentage.
Yeah, you know, I think Florida has made some great defensive adjustments. You look at the offensive numbers, they're better, but the defensive adjustments have been huge in the third and fourth set, holding Stanford below 100 in the third set.
Speaking of big, some big swings from Marina Markova for Florida.
Markova had some timely kills, out of system plays, and then to finish the last set inside the block when it counted for Florida.
11 kills. She has struggled with her serve with the three service errors, but when you talk about service mistakes, you think of Stanford. 18 service errors in this match. Could be over right now. Instead, we are going to a fifth set. Give a lot of credit to Florida. You're down two sets to none. Got a little quiet in the building, feeling a little down. They fought back. They were impressive in that third set, and they have kept the momentum going here. And now we have winner take all set five.
Well, every coach talks about it. What's the key? Serving and passing. I don't think Stanford's having a great passing night, and they're definitely not having a great service night. On the other side, I feel like Florida's been winning in both categories.
Who will win those categories here in the fifth? Freshman Alexis Stuckey will serve for the Gators. And it's a service error to start things here in the fifth. Now, a reminder, Stanford now does have a challenge. They were out of challenges, but now they get a challenge back. Florida has two challenges. You don't get an additional one in the fifth if you already have two heading into that fifth set. So two for Florida, one for Stanford. And a kill. Beeson, 1-1.
Stephanie did such a good job establishing Gabby Essex. That holds the middle blocker, freeing up Beeson on the outside to have one blocker in front of her. That's what you want. That is your goal as a setter, to isolate your hitters with just one block in front of them.
Canan. Good serve. Point Florida.
Florida knew they were going to have to work hard to get Stanford out of system, and they put a huge emphasis on their serving game, and it's paying off.
Emily Canan had three aces in her collegiate debut against North Florida this past weekend, and she's come up with back-to-back aces, the freshman delivering for the Gators.
Stanford's going to put Katie Baird back in the match, back into the serve-receive position. But Kanan coming out hot from the service line for Florida.
Three in a row!
The pace is unbelievable. She's going for it, keeping it in the court, but really impressive performance from the service line. I love it, especially in this fifth set.
Stanford calls a timeout. That allows the Emily Canan appreciation party to pick up a little stint. Look at the look on her face. That look was like, I can't believe what just happened. I just aced Stanford three straight times. And by the way, it's still your serve out of this timeout.
Yeah. People are bringing her water. She doesn't know what to do.
It was great. The Florida bench was into it. They were passing out over there. The crowd was into it. And that freshman has come through in the clutch. And we've talked quite a bit about these young players for this Florida team. This is a young team. Stuckey, the freshman setter. Canan comes in. Three aces in a row.
I think a lot of players who don't have a ton of experience are stepping up in big roles for Florida and are excited at the opportunity to be able to wear the Florida jersey and go out and perform in a big match like this for the Gators. Look at the movement on that ball and just enough pace to be disruptive. The team celebrates her. I love it.
Wasn't quite a Serena twirl right there, but she had her own little twirl going on to celebrate that ace. 4-1 Florida. Emily Canan. The ace streak is at four!
I don't think I've ever seen in a five set four aces in a row.
That one is long, and it's a point for Stanford. The service run ends for Emily Canan. Four straight aces put Florida on top 5-1.
Big impact so far for her in this fifth set.
In the end, the serve for these two teams is telling the story of this match.
It certainly has.
Service errors pile up for Stanford, 19, and Canan with the four straight aces, and now a service error for Florida. Stanford. Pilardi. A quick set. Good recovery from the knees, and that's off the hands of McKissick and a point for Stanford.
Kendall Kipp was falling down. But
yes.
Kept it alive. Good transition play for Stanford. And we're already able to get them out of system. That ball hit the antenna.
So it's a point for Stanford.
Stanford on a little run of their own, just down by one.
Good response by the Cardinal, who fell behind 5-1 on that service run by Canaan. So now Florida will take a timeout. We'll take the timeout as well. Gators on top by one, fifth set here in Gainesville. So many great non-conference matchups. This one on a Tuesday. Think what's coming up this week. Wednesday, Minnesota's at Texas. Saturday, Kentucky's at Creighton. Next Sunday, Ohio State's at Louisville. This Florida team's at Minnesota. Texas is at Stanford. So many great games, and this is getting us off to a great start this week. 12th-ranked Stanford, 13th-ranked Florida, and a service error out of the timeout by the Cardinal, and the Gators are back on top by two.
But Stanford was able to creep up in the score category, only down by two now.
That's got to be a half dozen out of timeouts. Florida catches the tape, and that one's long. Hitting error by the Cardinal. Florida stretches their lead to three, playing to 15. Here in this fifth set, teams will change benches and change ends with Florida. The first 8 points here in this fifth set.
31 hitting errors for Stanford. That's a huge number. So you talk about hitting errors and then service errors. That's a lot of points for the other team.
As a result, Stanford hitting at 178 for the match. So very quick changeover, we're ready to resume play. With Beeson serving. Good set there by Miner, and the kill by Katie Baird.
Looked like Cammy Miner sped that ball up to Katie Baird, giving her a little bit more speed to work with, and it pays off.
Victoria has it blocked. Stanford's defense stands tall at the net. Kendall Kipp was there.
Out of system play, but Stuckey delivered a well-located bump set. Victoria just got blocked.
Point for Stanford. Officials looked at each other just to confirm the call. Mary Wise will probably go to the challenge card here.
Pretty sure the linesman called it off the antenna.
All right, so as they take a look at the replay. The call on the court is point Stanford. Does this ball make contact with the antenna?
It does. Down low. Yep. Great camera work.
So first challenge used by Mary Wise tonight. Stanford unsuccessful in their two challenges. Quick review, and the challenge is unsuccessful. It's a point for the Cardinal.
All tied up.
So each team with one challenge remaining here in the fifth set. Miner back to serve. Tied at eight. And a block. Kendall Kipp.
Stanford's block right now scoring big points for them, but the serve in the court getting Florida out of system. Stuckey's had to bump set the last two balls.
Another good serve by Miner. Stuckey to Victoria. Ogilvy digs it out. Miner with a set and the kill for Stanford.
Ogilvy in a perfect position for Stanford to dig that ball. Even though there was only one blocker in front of her, she knew where that ball was going. And now Stanford on a 5-0 scoring run.
Remember, the Cardinal were down 5-1 in this fifth set, and they have come back. And as Holly mentioned, currently on a 5-0 run to go on top by two, and Florida has used their final timeout. So as they take a moment to talk it over, we talked about some of the great matchups that are ahead. You've taken a look at your crystal ball here, and there's plenty of matches that you are looking forward to, some more than others, and not just these non-conference matches, because remember, in volleyball, we get into conference play pretty quickly in the next couple of weeks, middle of September. So what are some of the ones that you're really looking forward to?
Well, next week, you and I get to work at Ohio State at Louisville. I'm also looking forward to seeing Texas at Stanford, Wisconsin versus Minnesota, Louisville, Nebraska, and Washington, Stanford, all matches where I think all those teams could go the distance.
That's all in the next month.
Yeah,
we are on August 30th. That's just taking a look in the next 4 weeks plus.
But those are all teams that I think are going to go long into the postseason.
This match has gone long into the night here in Gainesville, past the 2.5 hour mark, playing in the fifth set. Stanford building a little momentum here in set five. Starts with a serve for the Cardinal, coming out of a timeout. Can Cammy Miner keep it going? I don't know if I've seen anything like it. You've been around volleyball forever. You almost expect it at this point.
Yeah, I think when it keeps happening, then you let a little doubt creep in, and then
attention
it continues
to happen. Attention in your swing.
Yeah.
All right, so Florida trying to take advantage of the Stanford mistake. Good serve there. Off the hands of McKissick, point for the Cardinal. Back up on top by two.
Low pass that Cammy Miner got there to get that set lifted for Kip, and it pays off.
Overpass and a point for the Cardinal.
When Stanford serves the ball in the court and gets any type of out-of-system play, their defense is scoring.
Stanford 3 points away from a thrilling road win in Gainesville. Stuckey, Markova, point Florida. Don't count the Gators out yet.
Ellie McKissick, perfect pass for Florida, and they're able to get Markova in system. Look, it's Stuckey doesn't even have to move, and then Markova with the arm speed through the seam for the Florida point.
AC Fitzpatrick comes on to serve for the Gators. Set for Essex. That's going to go long.
I like the decision to go to Essex. It's probably her first error of the entire match. She's been the hot hitter for Florida.
Ogilvy back to serve for Stanford. Stuckey sets it for Markova. Blocked at the net by Stanford. Match point, Cardinal.
Sammy Francis worked extra hard to close the seam in that block. Markova has been attacking it all night long with success, but that time Francis shuts it down.
Kept alive. McKissick got it over. Bump back, and it drops in, and the Stanford Cardinal have won in five sets in Gainesville. What a match between the Gators and the Cardinal here tonight.
Stanford stole that fifth set. I felt like Florida was in such a good position after that really quick start with the four aces. But Stanford serving in the court in some defense, some strong blocks, that was the difference at the end.
Stanford with a comeback in set one. They won set two, and then Florida went to work in set three. They won set four, but then the Cardinal answer back in the fifth to win it here in Florida.
Free ball, Sammy Francis actually passes it over and then digs it back, pops over the net, and they cannot get it back. What a way to end that match.
So it's a victory for Stanford. They picked up a couple of wins in Nashville. And then they get a win here in Gainesville. They'll fly home to California coming up tomorrow morning. And then they'll get ready for another top 25 showdown, but that's something to worry about some other time. Kendall Kipp is joining us right now. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
Must feel like a thrill to come back like you did in the first set, fight off seven set points, and then after dropping back-to-back sets, to pull it out in the fifth.
Yeah, thrill is the great word for that. That was a hectic match, but I'm proud of our team for fighting through that.
And Coach wanted to see how you would fight and how you would compete. What did you think about your team's compete level here tonight?
I think there's still room for improvement. It was up and down at times, but I think we unlocked a new level of just fight and passion that we hadn't seen yet. So I'm really proud of our team for fighting all the way through that match.
One of the things you guys do traditionally is serve well. That was kind of off as a whole. What do you do when you're, as a whole, missing so many serves?
I think we start missing serves when we get tentative, so we just want to keep going back there, being aggressive, and hitting our game serve that we practice in practice every day.
Going into that fifth set, what was your game plan? What did you guys have to execute at a high level?
Just executing in general on our team. I think we started making more errors in the third and fourth set, so just keeping balls in play and playing harder defense and then getting them out of system with our serves was a goal of ours.
Going back to your middle attackers, was that something you guys tried to get going in that third and fourth set?
Definitely. We were trying to, as long as the passes were there, we were trying to get our middles involved to even out the offense a little bit more, and I think that helped our pins a great amount.
Kendall, it's very early in the season, so you're still learning about this team and learning how to win, and this was a pretty good lesson here tonight. When you guys are clicking, look down the line a little bit, what will Stanford volleyball look like this year when you're playing your best?
We're just hoping to be a team that puts constant pressure on other teams and makes them work, because we're not going to give them anything. We're just going to play lights out defense and execute our offense at a fast speed and serve tough.
And maybe unlocking those new levels like you did tonight.
Yeah.
So that's a good one to take back home with you. Congratulations on the win here tonight.
Thank you.
Kendall Kipp, big part of the victory for the Stanford Cardinal here tonight. They win it in five sets over the Florida Gators. Here in Gainesville, it was a thriller. Stanford took set one 31-29, set two 25-22. The Gators battled back to take set three and set four, but in the end, the Cardinals stay undefeated with a five-set win. For Holly McPeak and our entire crew, I'm Eric Creed. Thanks for being with us. So long from Gainesville.